Some motherfuckers are always trying to ice skate uphill.
Comic chest in the house. It's a little too wide for my grip. It's got some weight to it too, all right? Kind of an interesting theme for this month. It's fangs, you know, like... fangs. You know, things that got pointy teeth. Definitely a unique theme. I'm curious what we're gonna find. Got a flyer for next month. It's sci-fi. This type of design and pattern here definitely gives me that 80s synth wave vibe. You know what I'm talking about? Like, you know, on the top, first cover trading card series, Black Panther from July of 1988. That is wild. It's a trading card that's a print of a comic book cover. There you go. Black Panther, look at those fangs. Packing list, letting us know what's inside there. Informative, no big deal, no spoilers. My favorite, Yellow Starburst. Some Gargoyles trading cards from the 90s, what's up? You guys remember the episode where Lexington builds a motorcycle and then Brooklyn just takes it and then fucking wrecks it? Boom, got yourself a member of the Steel Clan. Cool robot Gargoyles. Ugh, Demona, the worst. Oh no, it's Goliath getting shot by a laser. Goliath probably got shot by Demona because she's a bitch. On to the comic chest theme cards. Ha ha ha, yes. This is so funny. Listen, okay. This card is a bit of a stretch, but it's fucking hilarious and I see what they're going for. We'll get to that in a minute. Of course Wolverine and Sabretooth, they got some fangs. Can't have a fangs box without the one and only Morbius. It's Morbin time, baby. I don't know how this happened, but somehow Colossus becomes a vampire? Come on now. The Haunted Mansion series. Got a Rogue too, I'm assuming Rogue is also a vampire. Again, not sure how that happened, but I'll take it. Night Stalkers, I think Blade's one of those guys. Speaking of Blade. I don't know if you guys have ever seen Demolition Man, one of the greatest movies of the 90s, but you got Simon Phoenix, played by Wesley Snipes, who also played Blade. Even if this is a tad bit of a stretch because it's the guy that played Blade, but not the character of Blade, I really love this because I love Demolition Man. If you've never seen Demolition Man, please watch it. Have a great time.
You will find display.
What about if we open a vintage figure? How about that? Oh, yeah, dude. Definitely a vintage figure, but this is an old school version of a vintage figure. Did that make sense? So yes, it's a vintage figure, but this is the old version of the comic book character. So it is my dude Sabretooth. This might be the original version of Sabretooth. He's got the orange outfit, he's got the furry boots, the furry collar, I love it. From 1992, whoa. So you see his chest here, and you swap it to, oh, he's got a scratch. Healed, injured, healed, injured. How about we open some HeroClix? In case you don't know what HeroClix are. Well, HeroClix are these mini action figures, the little dials on the bottom. What do you do with HeroClix? Oh, well, I'm glad you asked. You throw down with your nerd friends on a tabletop because it's a board game. You go head to head, you roll some dice, you go click, click, click. The last mini action figure standing is the one that wins. HeroClix. I might have to start doing that toward the end of the video because it takes a lot out of me. Oh yeah, big time fangs. So we got this guy called Reptil. I want to say reptile, but there's no E. Look, yeah, see this? Reptil. If you just threw an E there, then it wouldn't be a question. I would just say reptile. Yeah, he's got orange arms. Big deal. Look at that. See the dial on the bottom? That's how you play the game. See? Then you got Tigra. You know, looks like she's about to take a dump. Manwolf definitely gonna have some fangs there. See how he's got these like short shorts? These short yellow shorts? You think those are practical for changing into werewolf or what? And yeah, duh. Of course Venom's got fangs. He's got huge fangs. Looks like he's doing some stretching with his web, you know, because his web's a lot thicker than Spider-Man's for some reason. Venom firing off those thick webs, you know?
Another vintage figure, by the way. What do we got?
I think I know who this is. Blue Feet.
How sweet. We got a Beast, baby. Ooh, fuck yeah.
This is my favorite version of Beast. 1990s animated series Beast.
Perhaps you self-appointed social engineers don't realize the crucial role mutation plays in species evolution.
Get him!
I'm sorry, gentlemen. Your anger at the inexorable alienation of late 20th century life is sadly misdirected.
Hell yeah, that's awesome.
How cool is this, dude?
Look how good that looks for a figure from 1994, dude. That is the shit. Look at this guy. Awesome. Definitely a beast of a beast.
Comic chest. There they go again, swinging in, flicking on that nostalgia light switch. Got all my happy 90s X-Men memories popping up. A beast. Collectible.
Oh, wow. I'm going to leave the price tag on there because that's hilarious.
So in case you weren't aware, the comic chest includes a collectible figure. This one off the shelves from the 90s. If I had to guess, it looks like this is a villain from the Ghost Rider animated series, Outcast. Check it out.
Boom, fangs. He's got like glow-in-the-dark weapons. Look at this. That's how much an action figure cost in the 90s. What a deal. I'm sure it's worth a lot more than that now. Glow-in-the-dark weapons!
Yeah, so, oh. What the? It says it comes with a custom comic book included. Oh yeah, there is something back there. If there were only a way to get to this custom comic book so I could take a look at it.
Ah!
Neat. It's a cute little comic book, guys. Adorable.
All right, this is fucking amazing. It's a legit mini comic book. That's great.
I love that. Glad I opened the box. Let's take a look at this guy. 1996. Yeah, so many accessories.
Yeah, dude. I'm gonna see if I can get this glow-in-the-dark shit to work.
Gah!
Ho, 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 ho! Yeah, dude! That is awesome. It came with a belt made of skulls. That's metal as fuck. Let's get it going again.
Gah!
Yeah, ho, ho! Outcast, baby! That's a cool figure, dude. Check this out, too.
Ah! Man, they don't make them like they used to. Check this dude out. One last thing.
Fangs, definitely, but also flat top mullet that transitions into a fucking beard. A beard mullet flat top. Is there a better haircut?
The answer is no. There's not a better haircut than that. That got me amped up. How about some comic books, huh? We got 10 of them.
Oh, yes. So we got BPRD comic. Obviously, as you know, BPRD is where Hellboy comes from. They're investigating vampires. Couldn't ask for more. Check out the back. You got a comic grade card in there to let you know what it's worth.
On the streets.
That's dope. Apocalypse Dracula. Are you telling me Apocalypse kills Dracula? Yeah. Got yourself a Morbius comic. Morbin time. Love the shadow here. He's like all crying out sad over, I don't know, some dead chick. Did you kill her, Morbius?
Did you?
Oh yeah, you gotta have a Blade comic in there. Are you kidding me? Looks like Blade's up against some kind of, I don't know, pastor? Priest? Getting bladed? Darkness, look at the fangs on this sucker.
You know what these remind me of?
Have you guys ever seen the movie Attack the Block? These monsters remind me of those monsters. And then our series, we've got 30 Days of Night, which I love. I love 30 Days of Night.
Hot take, 30 Days of Night, best vampire movie.
Funny enough, this guy actually looks like Morbius. Not sure what's going on this cover, but the artwork is sweet. Nice and bloody and abstract, all about it. Oh, got your kind of classic 30 Days of Night image there.
That's pretty much what they've got on the cover of the movie poster. Not really sure what's going on here, another abstract one. It almost looks like she's doing math in a casino. Ah, you know the reference, huh? And you just got this guy holding a gun. But what's this? He's being stalked by a vampire. All right, that was a good one. Shall we recap? In this box, you got 10 comic books, one box collectible, two vintage action figures, a pack of HeroClix, and a pack of cards. Good comic chest, everyone. I really enjoyed it. If you want your own comic chest, I got links in the description. They're very easy to talk to, very easy to figure out. Get a custom box, get their monthly box, whatever. They're down. They're gonna give you something that you like. That's what they do. Okay? See ya.
Subscribe.